Yep, another free-for-all, you guys. And this time it's going to be 6 people free-for-all, not a 12 people. Good God, last game almost killed me. Holy Jesus, I can't believe I casted an hour and a half long replay. And I think it took me probably, I don't know, 3 hours to compile the whole video. And another 6 hours to upload to YouTube because it's freaking 4GB large because of 1080p. Anyway, I think I'm going to do another let's play and then conclude my 1 million view channel view special ready. Because I'm really running low on time. And I'm debating on if I should do another a 2-year special commentary. Because the specials are too so close together, it devalues the whole thing. I've done so many specials. Anyways, this is going to be on, looks like, what map is this on? Gold Rush? No. What? Well, I don't know what the map is. I think it's Gold Rush. I might be wrong. But I'm going to show you how buggy new I am. And looks like we're going to have Green's undead going clockwise. Dark Green's going to be Night Elf. Looks like he's going for Tavern build. Pink Night Elf is going for Demon Hunter, and we've seen what Demon Hunter can do in a free-for-all game last time, so let's hope he's going to repeat to live up to his Superman's name. 4 o'clock we have what? Where's the altar? Okay, here we go. I was going to say, where the hell is Human's altar at? He's going to pick an Archmage, the best aura in the game, also one of the weakest. And at the 7 o'clock, we have a Red Night Elf also going for a Tyrant build. Last game, I forgot to mention, I casted a game that on a map, 12 players did not have one Tyrant hero because it didn't have a Tyrant on the map. And this time, I'm going to cast a free-for-all where there's how many Tyrants are there on the map? I think there's one in the middle, and there's a lot of shops around the map. Watch this. Watch how many freaking map artifacts are there. I'm just going around the clock at one, separated by probably 60 degrees each around the clock. And we're going to see a lot of marketplace. And in later on in late game, the marketplace makes a lot of good items. I'm talking about Potion of Invulnerability, top of my head, Ring Protection plus 4. Sometimes it gets like Colossal Type plus 9. So the marketplace will be used later on. Let's see who would take advantage of those. Anyway, it looks like the Green Undead is going for a Fiend build. And here comes the DK. Don't kill that creep! Don't you kill that creep! There we go. Nice switch. There we go. DK is out, so you can continue to focus on that creep. And DK is going to probably come over and finish him off. Oh, use a coil! I don't know what he did that for. Maybe he wanted to creep a little faster. I really don't understand the logic. Maybe get this pair of skeletons faster? But he has a graveyard right here, so he could have gotten the skeleton. Looks like a Dark Green is going to creep somewhere, or he's going to go... Where is he going? He was going for a Tyrant build. I wonder who is going to get the first Tyrant hero. Tyrant hero is on cooldown yet, so we're not going to see one for a while. And... Oh, I'm sorry. Demon Hunter. What? He had a really late altar for a Demon Hunter. I really don't understand that. Who the hell? Where? There's an orc on the map? Am I blind? Oh my god, there's an orc on the map. Holy shit. At the 2 o'clock, I didn't even see that on the map. I thought that's a bunch of trees on the mini map. Apparently not. Look at the Demon Hunter's tanking a lot of damage in the creeping. Good thing nobody can see him. I mean, nobody has scouted him, and it looks like Purple is going to grab his Superman. He's going to creep Green Camp. I think everybody's creeping their Green Camp. Except, where the hell is Brown's hero? I'm gonna put Brown's vision on because he's the hardest to see. Also, he has an invisible hero I can select anytime I want. And Pion looks like he's gonna be spared. And Blamehouse are going straight for harassment. Gonna probably cancel or kill Wisp here. Again, I want to mention this is played on 1.244 patch, so the Windwalk is still last a little longer than 1.246. So really delayed reaction by Purple, lost 2 Wisps to the Blademaster. Now he's going to block the Blademaster inside his base. Let's see if Blademaster can use that item trick we've seen in the Chinese player used to do. Is he going to try to break out of the Moonwell? He's going to tank a lot of damage and try to break out of this. But the Demon Hunter is out of position. Archer needs to block this place. Archer needs to stuck in this position to hide so the Blademaster won't go anywhere. Oh god, the Blademaster was spared in a sense, although I don't know if Purple is ghostly enough to know that you can position your archers right around here and hide them all and take those positions to surround the Blademaster. But the Blademaster is going to get out. Good thing Purple is not that good a player. It looks like orcs are up. Every time orc does this, skip the barracks, go straight to tier 2, that's when you expand. You're not going to have orc have a tech advantage on you. You expand and tech at the same time. You can get away with it because one playmaster isn't going to do that much damage to you. Especially when you have a mountain king or a demon hunter. Anyway, it looks like the purple is going to try to creep to 12 o'clock. Let's see if it buys anybody out of the merc. I'm pretty sure it can buy a turtle. No, turtle on cooldown yet on the merc camps. Blade Master is going to creep this camp solo, probably looking for be level 2. Green is going to try to creep the middle camp. This is a big camp to creep for green at least. Although it's easier for undead than human or night elf because the chain lightning casted by this guy here isn't going to damage you as much. Blade Master looks like he's going to finish the creep camp off, gets to level 2, humans is going to expand like all humans do in the free-for-all. Red is going to pick a Dark Ranger. I don't know if he knows that the Dark Ranger is going to be really useless in the late game. Although I think everybody that is watching this video has seen the Chompesque series between Thu and Nicker. Teammates are duking it out back in the ECL 2010. I think Nicker joined Tailu after that game because he was so impressive versus Thu. Anyway, that's on Chompesque channel. I encourage everybody to look, check it out. And the Shadowhunter is out. He's going to grab some items. What is Orchid going to go for? He's food block, actually. He is food block. He has kind of noob fur from him. Maybe he's bad macro. Blade Master is going to creep a lot of camps. And along with the Shadowhunter, I don't know if the Blade Master wants to back off or not. Can build along the lightning shield on the Blade Master to harass people's economy. Jesus, that Blade Master. Oh, sorry about that. My computer is acting up again. I think it's protest me casting these free-for-all replays that probably isn't going to last another hour. Oh god, I just look at the replay bar, I just keep saying to myself, god, why didn't I grab a water before this or a beer or something? Anyway, human is going to expand and he's not going to face any pressure from anybody. So it looks like he's not going to tower up as much and he's going to tech to tier 2. I wonder where he's going. After knowing that, he's not getting any pressured, maybe he's going straight to tier 3 and go mass air, seeing that many footmen on the ground. I don't think he's going to get a lot of tier 2 units, unless he's going to go for another mass flying machine build again. There's a chain lightning I'm talking about. Not a big deal versus undead, because there's a skeleton going to wander around, seeing this undead creeping camp from red. So, like I said in the last game, early free-for-all games are just a big clusterfuck. You don't know what's going to happen. So you gotta play really defensively, not like these players are doing, because none of them are really aggressive. And looks like here's a crab you can hire. I think there's a level 4 turtle you can hire as well. I forgot what this guy can do. I think it's ensnare. I gotta look it up. I think he can ensnare. I'm not sure. That gotta be one of the reasons human god is because of the ensnare you can use to surround any solo enemy heroes. Holy god, these players are so freaking aggressive. They have no idea if they can. They don't really consider the possibility of getting creep jacked. Anyway. So everybody's going to expand, looks like, yep, everybody is going to expand, including the undead, which is big bad news, is bad news for everybody around the map, because if you allow this undead to have equal bases with everybody, that's going to be, you got overrun by tier 3 units and a bunch of high level heroes. Anyway. Red, it looks like he's the only one who hasn't expanded. Well, I'm sorry, he did. So everybody expanded except Brown. Never mind, he's going to expand as well. So everybody expanded. Big macro game. I might as well just speed up this replay because since everybody expanded, we're not going to see any action until later on. And it looks like there's some action. And Fiend is going to be focused on right away. And Fiend is going to try to focus on Raider. One Raider is going to be spared. The second Raider is going to be focused on by everybody again. And the Blade Master is going to be a point focus target. Pretty good micro by the green undead, just from the look of these focus fire. Our forces are under attack. Looks like these raiders are going to back off. I don't know if the orc wants to engage his undead army because he hasn't seen the lich. Here comes the lich. You don't know what lich has. You don't know if he has Nova or Frost armor. So if you can stare a fiend, and the Lich is gonna frost armor that fiend, and there's nothing to do. Okay, there's Lich getting snared. Where's Undead going? He's gonna lose the Lich. Lich gonna get coiled. Here's Nova. Actually, Lich picked Nova. I really don't know about that because he should have saved that Nova. I don't know what Orc is doing here with three Raiders. He lost one already. It looks like the creeps are gonna be aggravated, and now the creeps are gonna be attacked. And what is Doc Green complaining about? What's going on here? Did I miss engagement? I don't know. Christmas already. I have no idea what's going on here. Maybe, oh, he lost a panda. I think Purple picked off a low HP panda from Doc Green. That's what they're talking about. Not too big a deal because the level 2 hero early on, if you can get a right unit composition, it's still going to be pretty.
Job's done.
It's still going to be pretty easy to make up that disadvantage. Looks like I was wrong. Humans are gonna go for a tier 2 push, getting two Arcane Sanctums, and he forgot a blacksmith. That's why he's building it late, because he's gonna tag on a workshop here soon, because he has 2k gold in the bank. Also, he's over 50 food, so I really don't know what humans doing without a workshop. Blademaster is at level 3, so he is going to do some scouting. The Shadow Hunter should have cast his Wand of Lightning Shield on the Blademaster before the Blademaster went to Windwalk, and the Blademaster can go for ass. And Blademaster looks like he's going to get a Orb of Lightning, but the only one way he can get it is to get a tier 3. I wonder what tier 3 tech is going for. Blademaster kind of low though, getting level 1 chain healed by the Shadow Hunters for some reason. I really disagree with that. Orc is gonna tower up in the meantime. He's gonna force defense and orb of lightning. I think that's the only two tier 3 option. No, of course another hero. Okay, so he's good. I was gonna say that's pretty expensive options if you're gonna go for tier 3 for just those two options. And Orc is gonna get his expansion harassed by a bunch of human units. These footmen don't have defend yet. I don't know what Archmage is doing here. Okay, he's gonna have to focus fire this watchtower. And the human is better off just picking off his peons. But here comes the Orc heroes. He has only one unit. He's gonna go after the Archmage, and Archmage looks like he's gonna be TP. He's gonna try to TP out, I think. He's gonna have to. Oh, Archmage gets stomped, and he's gonna be hexed, and he's gonna be picked off. Archmage did not have time to cast a TP, gets stomped and hexed. Really nice timing. And now the Mountain King is trapped, and Shadowhunter is gonna be in trouble. Shadowhunter is gonna kill himself. Mountain King is gonna be killed, I think. One walk. Okay, never mind. There goes the Mountain King, so all these units are gonna be dead meat. Humans retreat right now, leave the Water Mantle behind if he has to. But humans are gonna try to pick off this. No, he is gonna try to back off. There's no way you're gonna fight these three heroes with only units. And looks like Green's gonna get a third hero. It's gonna be a Dreadlord. And I think he's gonna pick Carrion Swarm. I'm not sure. Maybe Sleep on the first hero point. I really don't know. I missed it. I missed if he cast anything, although he has full mana. I think Dr. Green and Purple are gonna duke it out here in a second, but although Purple is out of position, has three Night Elf mini nuke going here. I'm talking about a Mana Burn, Entangle, and Shadow Strike. A little Night Elf mini nuke, nothing compared to the Undead nuke though. If Undead has that Naga Sea Witch, that's gonna be really big back nuke, big fat boy style nuke. Or little man or fat boy? Fat man, little boy? I really don't know. I gotta look up the names of those nukes. Whatever. Looks like Orc is gonna stick with the below 50 food still. He hasn't gone over 50 food. Little lone priest. What's up, dude? You healing? Are you healing yourself? And the human's waiting for his two heroes to come out. And here comes the green, I'm sorry, red. Here comes Red Army. He's gonna be counter pushed by the undead, so he's gonna force the TP out. Green was saved by Teal was saved by his fellow green, similar color. Archer's gonna go down so fast versus his undead heroes, and let's see if he's gonna go for nuke for his priestess of the moon. Looks like not. And here comes the Chimera's going to reinforce. That's when Undead needs to TP. Oh, he's going to kill one of his own fiends. He could have just TP'd and used a Dark Ritual or something on the fiend. He killed it. Maybe Lich picked Frost Armor the second. I really don't know. Just kidding. I don't know what he's trying to do. good choice. Okay. I think Green would have TP'd right after he saw those Chimeras coming, because I think Red is the host. I'm not sure, though. Cloud, that name looks really familiar. I might have chatted or played with against him on Battle.net a while ago. His name looks pretty familiar, though. Orcs are going to slap on three Beasteries and two Voodoo Launchers. Is he running that big economy? No, he's on two bases. Like 20 million towers. This Orc needs to switch to human if he had a chance. But all the inside gold mines are going to be occupied, I think. All the gold mines are going to be occupied. Red is going to be running on three bases. They cannot allow this to happen. One of them has to do something about this economy. Is Red below 50 food? No, Red is going straight to high upkeep, so he's not going to. He's running three gold mines just to getting upgrades and making units every once in a while, because that's what happens when you're in high upkeep. You can barely afford any upgrades and units, let alone like buying items for your and mercs. Who the hell keep buying mercs? Okay, one sapper. I think he's gonna try to distract the undead and bomb the sapper right here. That's what I would do if I got a sapper. That's what I'd do. Anyway, human's gonna be in full reach strength, but he still has only tier 2 units. Everybody else has tier 3 except this guy. This guy has been below. This brown orc has been below 50 food the entire time. Okay. And he's still at 49. He needs a TP right here unless he doesn't have one. He doesn't have a TP, so he's gonna lose some units. He's gonna try to slow down the Demon Hunter. Demon Hunter's about to be level 5. Talk Green's there. And I think there's a panda him somewhere. Okay, here we go. And now Brown's gonna try to run around back to his base. Let's see if there's another mana burn or a stomp on the Clone Chieftain. Mana burn, come on, there we go. That's only level 1 mana burn. Oh, he spent the first hero point on Immolation, I forgot. But that Torn Chieftain is going to be picked off with one more Breath of Fire. No, a level 2 Chain Heal is going to keep that Torn Chieftain alive. And now Night Elf saw all these towers, so he's going to have to get some siege weapons like Chimeras or even... Oh, where's he going? Where are you going, buddy? Oh, he's going to get pushed by Purple. There's a big air battle. Griffin, Hippogriff on Hippogriff action here. Running wild, and we're gonna see the Demon Hunter is gonna be focused on Purple. Demon Hunter is gonna be focused on by almost everything. Green outnumbered Purple in the air. Looks like he's gonna be forced to TP, losing the Keeper of the Grove. This is some good mana right here. And yeah, nah, I really don't know what Purple is doing right there. He had an expansion. Everybody has one base except Red, but Red is in high upkeep, so that doesn't really count. Four Crypts. What is he doing? Holy God. Holy Jesus, this is one of the biggest macro games I've ever seen. This is almost like a freaking StarCraft game, to be honest. Look at how many Beasteries are there. Holy God. What is going on here? Oh, yeah, of course. How many production buildings? I can't even count on two hands how many production buildings are there. Three Chimera Roosts and two Ocean Winds are going to go up to the Undead Air Army to take down those Chimeras, and I think the Lichens got to Nova just to slow down this Chimera advancing. At least still slow down the effing fag. Because if you don't get anti-air, you call the other player a bad name. Are you kidding me? And also you pick two bad heroes. Panda's gonna be nuke first, and looks like the Dark Mirror is gonna be second here. Watch, Red is gonna quit after this. I predict Red is gonna quit. Lost everything. He lost absolutely everything. He's not even making anything. He's trying to revive his one of the heroes. Let's see if he's gonna tavern the other two back. No, it looks like not. I don't know what Red is going to do here. He's gonna lose a lot of stuff. I think he's gonna lose the entire base. I don't know if Undead wants to stick around and find out. And DK is gonna hit level 6, and I don't think we're gonna see Raise of Dead until very late, because the really, really nice manner, dude. Maybe that's how I remember Cloud's name. I really don't know. Okay, so all these gold mines are going to be on not mining, but Red almost mined out that one, and he's about to run out of this one as well. Mine out, I mean. So I don't know what if that's really worth it. His main actually has more money than those two expansions. Green looks like he's gonna go and probably kill some towers, although the only heroes can benefit from that is going to be the Lich and the Dreadlord, so he's going to leave the Lich and Dreadlord over here to soak up some experience. And then have the DK, where is he going?
Done.
He's going to do some shopping. And he's going to run into a big human army. Holy God. Holy Jesus. Done. DK by himself. And he's going to get ensnared here. Boat ensnared. Probably light to follow. DK needs to get out. What? Dude. Is Green even paying attention? Dude, he's going to have to TP or charge one of these healing items. No, looks like Teal is going to back off. Suspecting Green is going to push him. Dr. Green is going to call peace. I have no idea why. He's going to try to... what? I'll let you get ready, Expo. What? I don't know what Brown's doing. I have no idea. Brown's banking money. He's been banking money for the entire game. Finally spending some on some Batriders. That's the only thing he made. Some Witch Doctor probably, throwing down some Watch Reward. Pretty underrated ability and unit. It looks like Undead is going to take over the red expansion, although I don't... Whoa, that's 1080. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I thought it was 1,810 gold left. Apparently it's 10,000. So that's a really big gold mine. I was wrong when I said red has more money in the main. And that's 15,000. Okay, so I thought red mined out the entire thing. And, okay, I think Dr. Green is going to go 150 food. Green is going to 150 food, 100 food. Otherwise, you wouldn't have these two acolytes going, I don't know what is going on here. I have no idea. I thought he's going to go for high upkeep and have all the workers idle so he preserves some money. But apparently not. Yeah, GG and best of luck. I think Purple just left because he just lost another battle versus... versus this Doc Green guy. Doc Green's gonna GG him out, and he's gonna stay. He's gonna detonate all the wisps. Okay, I don't know what. Now he's gonna quit. If you're gonna quit, just quit. What's the point? Who detonating wisps? I don't know. Anyway, so Doc Green is gonna get some experience here, and I don't know what Doc Green is wild about. Oh, he's gonna get pushed by human. 3-on-1. I think he was by Brown someone earlier, and then complete. Purple, and now Teal somebody is going to push him. Is complete. Undead is going to be on three bases now, and that's going to be a freaking force to be reckoned with. His main was taken out, I think, by Brown. Brown's going to come back for another round of raid. 1-1 upgrades on the birds. 0-1 upgrade on the raiders. I think the armor upgrade is applied to all orc units, not just air or ground. That's one thing good about orc. Not a lot of people know about that because when you upgrade armor, all units benefit it, including grunts. All non-casters benefit from it. That's what I'm trying to say. Now, I really like what the Brown did here. He took out the main first before going after these acolytes, so Green won't be able to TP back. Although I think that Necropolis was under construction anyway. He's gonna get a little water ward over here, and he's gonna keep an eye on this expansion. Let's see if he can. Yeah, there you go. Now Brown can just maybe come back later. The correct way to do this is not to attack right away, but to wait until this thing finishes and then come back and attack. Because now Green's gonna cancel. See. He's gonna cancel. He didn't lose a lot. He lost an acolyte, but round of ETF, dude. The right way to do it is to come back right before it finishes and take out the main so he can TP and then take out the gold mine or the acolytes. Give your opponent a fake sense of security. I might never have been battling y'all game for it. Now he's gonna lose another one. Let's see if Green TP is back. Now he's gonna try to TP. Now he's gonna go now, sometime today. Dude, oh, the DK is not even anywhere here. Where the hell is the DK? Oh, God. He's gonna lose another gold mine. He's gonna be, oh, I'm sorry. DK is gonna be around here, but he doesn't have a TP anyway. He's gonna have to pop the potion as a raw ability and get out of here. He's gonna have to sell all of these things. Coil or Batrider didn't even kill him. He's not even selling any of this. He's gonna get all the, oh, God. Watch this. Nice Stoneform micro, and that there goes your Frostworm. And our gargoyles are going to survive the engagement, but he lost the Frostworm. Probably is gonna get a Shadowhunter kill, maybe. Let's see if the there's a coil, and he's gonna go after that Torn Chieftain. Torn Chieftain's gonna be slept again. There's Nova. There's a coil, and there's a focus fire. Damn, the Torn Chieftain. Pretty good exchange by Green, although he lost a bunch of acolytes. Pretty good trade though, I still say. I think now Green figured out why Brown knows where he is. Oh, the Tyrant Hero is gonna be right here. I don't know if Green's gonna follow all these units home, but he's gonna see these really low HP heroes. Is he gonna push all the way to Brown's base, or he's gonna chill here in the middle of the map, Dr. Green? Is he gonna call in his ally, or he's gonna get him pushed? Don't say God, get Jujitsu hit Green. That's just mass battle me. It's a game of Risk, I guess. That's what they're playing. I don't know what game I'm watching, but they think they're playing Risk. Anyway, it looks like the Browns are going to be running out of money here in the main, I think. No, everybody is out of money, except Teal, because he was harassed earlier by Red, so he's going to have some gold left over. I mine gold. Not because he has advantage or anything, just because he didn't get the gold on time, which is almost a disadvantage if you haven't mined that out yet. In the long run, it's pretty much the same, almost the same. This big air army is going to have to be supplemented by a bunch of flying machines. I don't see any flying machines in the air, but humans are going to try to rebuild his air force. And Blame Master is going to be slept. No, Blame Master is going to escape. Oh my god. That's going to teach Blame Master twice. Wrong key. Try that again. I think he was trying to cast sleep. Instead, he hit a W. Okay, I don't know what happened. Sleep is E. W. Karen Storm is W. So he meant to hit E to sleep the Blame Master, but instead he hit W. A little mistake by Green, and now Green took out all the Sentry Ward around his base, so he's gonna be fine as far as scouting goes. And Blademaster is crippled, which means Orc is gonna have to turtle even more. Although he's running on two bases, so I don't know what his concern is. And looks like Dr. Green is gonna breach this contract, the little verbal contract between him and Brown. Is he going to push into the Brown base? I don't know. Maybe he's just creeping here or something. Provo is going to be left alone. Who the hell? Is that Doc Green? Doc Green is going to try to take Purple's base, using his buildings to be like a little buffer for his main. Three exos of Green just got him up. That's what I told her. And just kind of, this is a really good mannered game. I'm really glad that I'm casting this. I really don't know if I should do another Let's Play, because I haven't got a lot of requests for them. Like, I think three people might have suggested me to do to continue on with those. I like to finish them because things I'm finished. Like if I quit a job or something, I make sure all my work is done before I quit, or when I leave a job, like when I'm co-oping or interning, and I just like to finish what I started off with. That's just me. That's why I want to finish at least a human part of the Let's Play. Looks like the Blade Master is gonna come back and pick off that low HP Haunted Goldmine. Really bad miss, big mistake by Green leaving that unrepaired, and now he's gonna be learning his lesson, try to get this Necropolis back online, back in full HP. Blade Master is at level 4, it's not that difficult to it's not that difficult to repair that Haunted Gold Mine. Really, Green should be blaming himself on that, not to Brown. Brown just took advantage of something that one of his mistakes. Green's gonna mine out of this camp mine in a second. Out of his main, he's mining on here. Let's see how much money Green is actually banking. Holy god, an undead race has almost 3k gold. That's one scary, scary thing to have. And looks like undead is gonna go for that standard undead build in the free-for-alls. Now Brown's gonna come in, try to form one. Oh god. Now he's gonna try to run back, kill this thing. Let's see if he's gonna TP out. Brown's going to run straight into green. Oh, nobody wants to engage. And looks like Brown's going to TP out of here. See ya. Teal is 100 food. Is that right? How did he know? 85. Oh, it looks like 100. Look at this thing. That's not impressive. He's going to be running. Oops, sorry. He's going to be running on a lot of gold mines. Looks like Dark Green is going to breach his verbal contract. Two Demon Hunters. Oh, God. No one of them is a fake. Fire Riders are going to do a lot of damage against air, though. But these heroes aren't going to stand up against this level 4 hero. Demon Hunter needs to focus down this Blade Master. I don't know what the Demon Hunter is doing here. Priestess Moon can TP out. And the Demon Hunter is going to be fine. Do a Mana Burn right before TP. Nope. Okay. So Doc Green escaped with all the heroes intact, but he lost all the Air Force. And Green's next. I really like, I'm loving this. Just to see. You do need to stop teaming. Okay, probably chatting with each other. He's the one that wants to Doc Green to attack Green, so I don't know what he's bitching about teaming. Anyway, looks like the one of the goggles is going to be picked off. I really don't think anybody wants to charge into Brown's base with all these towers intact. Although he lost his tier 2 tech, tier 3 tech, so he might want to do something here about his tech. If he keeps losing production buildings or something. Nice! Oh, nice! What? How much is, holy god, that's a lot of mana on that destroyer. He might want to take advantage of that. Nice. Who the hell is this far, by far the strongest? I didn't even read that. Is the Lich going to do a Dark Ritual later on this? I'm only suspecting. No Freezing Breath upgrade. Looks like Green's gonna muscle his way into this tower forest. I really don't think so. He's gonna kill a lot of peasants here though. He's found a weak point in the Brown's base. He's gonna took out this burrow, and back off, I think. Oh, he can kill some peons. Blade Master, you really don't wanna charge into this. You're gonna be slapped. Holy god. There's Nova, there's a coil. Blade Master is at 200 HP, so he doesn't wanna throw his face again. There's a shade around, so he can potentially just dust or throw Watcher Sentry Ward right here to spot that shade. Although the Watcher Ward won't survive long because there's each gonna be revealed by the shade. Look, Brown's gonna lose a lot of burrows. He's gonna have to rebuild. Never mind. Okay, right outside Brown's base, there's a big engagement between these teal and Dark Green. Dark Green's gonna lose his Demon Hunter in Metamorphosis form. That's gonna be big embarrassment. Dark Green's gonna be outnumbered like 3-1, although he's still holding his ground. Not for long. Bannon King is going to. Oh, Panda's gonna split. Panda's gonna split. No, Panda's gonna escape. Yes! Phew! That was close. You got egg. Say that's close. Where the hell did that Demon Hunter go? Where? Okay. I thought the Demon Hunter would be the first one to soak up Moon Juice. But it looks like Teal is going to win that battle, although he didn't kill a lot because he focused firing on the Demon Hunter and the Panda. So he didn't kill a lot of units. At the same time, he's going to charge into Brown's base. Nope, he's not going to, I don't think. He can potentially get some... I think Teal is the only one that can get some cloud and get these towers down easily without too much casualty. Level 6 Dreadlord. Brown, you know what you're getting into, right? Oh, God. Stone Form! bitches! Bitches! Diving this time, sons of bitches. Oh, God. Destroyer, I can't Stone Form. Okay, never mind. He dived into the Frost Worm. Level 2 Frost Armor. Looks like he's going to be committed to this Frost Armor thing on the Frost Worm. So the Backriders won't do as much damage. Also, level 7 DK is going to coil the Frost Worm a lot. I'm not paying attention to the chat because I'm trying to look on the minimap to see what's going on. This is like fourth time Green trying to rebuild his position. Green's not going to let that go. Brown's not going to go anywhere, let's face it. He's not going to go anywhere because Green is camping outside his base just to try to catch him doing anything. Owl Scout is going to do some spotting. You cannot dispel Owl Scouts, so you might as well just say hi and just move along. And is Green's going to spot this? Because this is not as nearly as defended as this. Although equal amount of towers, you don't have the buildings in front of towers or the entire Orc army to defend it. So you can potentially take that out. the Owl Scout just follows Green anywhere he goes. Doc Green is pretty useful with his Owl Scout. I wish I know what level Owl Scout this is. Although level 1 Owl Scout lasts like half a year, and level 2 Owl Scout lasts 2 years. Level 3 Owl Scout lasts, I don't know, the entire game. Might as well just have a permanent owl just flying around like a phoenix. Doc Green's gonna be pushed. Where's he going? Dude, Green's... What? He canceled his TP? I thought he was TPing somewhere. Big great engagement here. Again, we're gonna see the Frostworms. Chimera's gonna be focused down first. Mountain King's gonna go down first, though. Stop focusing down the Demon Hunter! Don't focus down that freaking Superman! Green, oh god, Teal is gonna lose this entire game because he focused down the wrong unit. Archmage is gonna try to get out with the TP. He's gonna save 2 units. This Sorcerer wasn't even in the battle. Did he even lose the Paladin? No, he didn't. Where the hell is the Paladin? Okay. Paladin was trying to rendezvous. Green just had a good laugh. Dr. Green just had a good laugh at that. And the priest would be like, "May the name of the Lord compel you! May the name of the Lord..." Never mind. try to cast some exorcism. Whatever. Dr. Green is going to try to tower up here. Oh, he's going to... What? I thought these were towers. He's going to get more production buildings. He's going to run out of money here. Oh, he's going to stop mining. I think he's going to stop mining. No, he's still in mining. I don't know what he's doing. He's at 50 food, so he might as well saturate this base. Has wine wisping there. I don't know. Maybe he thinks that firewoods aren't worth it to get a 1,000 gold out of it in a hurry. Because he's at 50 food already, he doesn't want to make more wisps. What is he doing? Getting a dropship or some shredder or something? What the hell is going on? Oh, nice! So Green's not going to bother with this brown anymore. I think he's going to... Oh, 3 sappers. I think he's going to sack this base. Where is Green, to be honest? Is he his own base? Where are his 2 heroes? He lost both to brown. Oh, I missed it because it happened simultaneously with the brown, with the green, teal and green battle. Oh god, hey teammate. Doc Green, WTF? Doc Green is going to be teaming up with brown now, and he's going to take out 2. Green lost 2 bases in a matter of half a minute. So I don't know what the Green's going to do. He has enough money to do anything he wants. 5k gold is more than enough. And here comes Owl Scout just to check out the base. And he's going to see the unit composition as well. He's going to see 4 crypts, all pumping gargoyles. I think this might be a time to switch to... whoa, never mind. Okay, it looks like the Doc Green is going to go straight into Green's base. Green has only 1 hero. The second hero is almost out. Lich looks like he's gonna be out. Now is it gonna be a big push? Lich has got to cast Nova, chuck the potion mana if you have to. There's a Nova, I think he chucked the potion mana on the Priest of the Moon. Priest of the Moon's gonna have to TP here if she's not microed. There's goes to TP. I think there's an archer is gonna be focused on next. Is he Demon Hunter? Nope, Demon Hunter is not going to. Why do you kill me? What? What happened? I have no idea what Teal is. I think he's bluffing. Where are his things anyway? What the hell happened? Oh, Brown killed Teal. Teal's noob anyway. He shouldn't focus on that Demon Hunter to begin with. I think he was trying to do a little motor team trick, but I think he was caught by the Watcher Ward or Sentry Ward. I don't see any Sentry Ward on the mini map. Maybe he was caught in the wrong time. Green still has a hidden base here, only 3 acolytes, but he has more than enough money to do anything he wants, but just not enough food. Look at it, 60 max food. So he's gonna have to rebuild a bunch of ziggurats, and he's gonna have to wait for the hero to revive. And 3 sorcerers, really, they're gonna kill 3 acolytes. Acolytes can just turn around and fight back, right? Green really cries a lot. Brown's gonna catch 1 acolyte. 2nd acolyte is going to be spared. Looks like sorcerer is gonna back off. I really don't know what's going on here. Maybe out of mercy. I really don't know. It's GG anyway. Go ahead. Summoning is complete. I don't know why Green calls GG because he has plenty of anything. He has a shredder here somewhere. What the hell? Okay, he has a shredder here somewhere, give him constant lumber income, and he can later on use the shredder to win the battle. Although I don't know how long it's gonna last, because these hero levels are getting pretty high up. Dr. Green, where's he going? Up is he gonna wander around the map? He's actually the strongest hero, the player of them all. Level 7 Demon Hunter, 6-6. Pretty big hero. Batrider, diving, dive! Dude, no! Dude, there we go. Now Batrider's gonna be diving. Okay, here come the heroes. Chimera's gonna be caught for sure. Gonna be purged here, and he's gonna be hexed. And purge is gonna cancel the hex, but still he's gonna be trapped. Here comes the rest of the green army. He's gonna try to come in, kill that Chimera. Yes, right before the TP. Oh, nicely done. So what? One Chimera trading a TP, pretty good trade. Although Doc Green's gonna be enraged by that little exchange. He's gonna try to kill Brown. Brown, these towers aren't gonna do jack versus Chimeras. Doc Green's hitting there. Oh, they got! Oh, say bye to your Air Force, dude. Breath of Fire is way late. Oh, God. Die, dude. Rider is gonna get killed. Still, Demon Hunter is gonna clear up all these towers, and Brown's gonna be in danger losing all the production buildings. He does not have tier 3 tech, so if he loses, and not even tier 2 tech, so if he loses any of the Beasteries or Spirit Launch, he cannot rebuild it until he gets tier 2. And now this is just stubborn, keep making Batriders to try to counter those Chimeras. Here comes the heroes. I really disagree with this. Try to focus on the Demon Hunter. Demon Hunter can be just staffed back. Staff Demon Hunter, what the hell? Oh, dude, Prison Little has two TPs. He didn't pass one to the Demon Hunter. And, Doc Green is still in a good position. The Batriders continue to stream out, and I think they're going to use it. They're going to be used to the Chimeras. One of the Chimeras will definitely be killed. Chimeras are level 3 armor, so it's going to take them a while, though. Brown looks like he's going to back off. Yeah, there's no other options because that Demon Hunter kill took a lot of damage. He took a lot of damage in that Demon Hunter kill. At least he got that level 7 hero out of the way. Dr. Green looks like he is going to revive that. He has more than enough money to get that out of the tavern. I don't know why he's not getting it. I don't know if you guys caught it, but Dr. Green casted a Starfall, but after that he used a potion of anti-magic. So he's a Starfall, isn't going to, he's on cooldown right now. Breath of Fire, Drunken Haze on the Shadowhunter. Shadowhunter has a potion of lesser availability on him. He's going to have to pop it here, but the Priest of the Moon is the one in trouble. He cannot risk his, she cannot risk a critical strike from the Deep Blade Master, so she was forced to hide. Blade Master is gonna be fair fired. He's gonna have to back off all these two heroes, and they can be cycloned. They can be cycloned. No, don't worry, going cyclone. This he's gonna get killed by a dot. He's gonna really get killed by a dot. Nope, there's a cyclone, and here we go. Deep Blade Master is gonna be killed. Shadowhunter is gonna have to back off. Blade Master is gonna be killed. One more hit. There we go. And the Shadowhunter is gonna be spared, and Brown left the game. Nicely done, nicely done. And what are these peasants doing here? What's going on here? Really, this is experience feeding. 70 mana for Breath of Fire. Do it, Breath of Fire. I know Breath of Fire isn't gonna be enough to kill these peasants. They're gonna take him down to 20 HP. But still, could have used that Breath of Fire on those peasants. Brown's going to leave. That leaves Green's been macroing up the entire time. He didn't fight a single battle. That's going to be a big, scary army to face. Especially his 3-3 upgraded all-air undead army. Two Frostworms, bunch of Gargoyles, and two Destroyers. And you can counter anything in the way except a bunch of Batriders, because you cannot kill Batriders fast enough. You can use Karen Swarm and the Nova to nuke them all in a hurry. Oh, Demon Hunter's gonna be caught! Oh, he's gonna be past the entire undead army! And Demon Hunter's got to hurry up, he has a boost of speed, so he's gonna have to back off really fast. And Princess of the Moon's gonna be caught next! And she's got to TP back. Oh boy. Bad rally point. And there's another Chimera that's going to be rallied to the heroes. And I don't know what Green's doing over there. He's going to have to straight heading straight to the Dr. Green's main. Dr. Green's got to TP back. There it goes. Down goes the Priestess of the Moon. That just means these, where are these heroes? They were trapped. Where are Dr. Green's heroes?
Our sacred grove is being desecrated.
I think they were buying TP in force. Yeah, getting a TP just in case Dr. Green goes straight into his main. He can defend.
Timing
back
the
Priestess of the Moon. All three heroes has all of momentum. That's interesting. Here we go. Here comes the TP. That's a too many Chimeras, I have to say. Not enough to counter the Gargoyles. That might be the downfall of Dr. Green, though. Here we go. Big battle. Karen Swarm and... Oh, dude. Coil and... No more sleep? No sleep? Okay. Here we go. Here's a Inferno. Okay, he was casting Inferno without sleep. And Inferno is going to be the big badass in the middle. He cannot do anything. Look, the only thing can damage Inferno by Dr. Green is going to be the heroes. Here's a Starfall, which means the Priest of Moon is going to be slapped. That's an easy counter. And Inferno looks like he's going to be killed. A lot of experience is going to be fed. And Gargoyle is going to be all Breath of Fire, Drunken Haze, so that's going to be a big deal. Priest of Holmes is trapped, I'm sorry, whoever that is trapped in that Stoneform maze. I think it was a Priest who was forced to TP out of there. And Legends, be careful, Legends to TP now, oh god. And Dreadlord is going to TP again. Christ. Oh god, undead. Jesus. So Dr. Green didn't lose a hero, and Undead lost two. How did you do that? Oh, man. God. Had a perfect unit composition. I guess he charged into a bad position. And, of course, Moonwell did a lot to save those heroes. He's going to Tavern one of them back, at least. Who's going to Tavern back? Dreadlord, and I think Lich is on the way out, yep. Most efficient way to do it when you lose three heroes. And Teal, I think, is Teal still here? If Teal comes back and win the whole thing, I swear to God, I don't know what I'll do. I'm gonna do something. If humans somehow behind this entire game and come back and win, I don't know what I'll do. He has one mining base, four peasants on gold, and he, I don't think there's another base. No, he doesn't, and he's gonna leave a griffin behind, of course. Why not? Not reviving his heroes. I really don't see how he's gonna come back. What's going on here? No more gold mine left on the map. Looks like, well, this one occupied by green. Green's gonna get another one here, walking his tree all the way from purple's main, and that's the only two gold mines left. Looks like on the map. Oh, there's one here occupied by green as well. Green has a two gold mines. Holy shit! Anyway. Another big engagement. I think Doc Green is pushing his luck this time because you don't want to charge into the undead base. Make the mistake your opponent made, charge into your base with the Breath of Fire. I think he's trying to food block the Lich or something. He did block the Lich from the altar, but let's see if the Acolyte rebuild the altar or he's gonna tavern the Lich. I don't know. You can tavern the dead heroes without the altar though. What is Akana doing here? So is Green gonna do it without Lich? That's a big mistake. There's a Grand Haze Breath of Fire, Stone Form, and come straight back up. That's right, Mike. Looks like Green is not gonna have enough units to deal with this. Try to get some Gargoyles out. I don't think that's gonna be on time. These Gargoyles better stay in Stone Form until these Gargoyles come out so they can form a big counter push. But in the meantime, he might lose Tier 3 tech. That's a big no-no. Gargoyles gonna come out of Stone Form, kill two. Hippogriff right away. Nice shift click by right there. DK is gonna be really weak versus this level 7 Demon Hunter. About to be, level 8 now. About to be level 9. And no more spare towers, or there's one spare tower in the way. But Undead lost his main. Lost his tier 3 tech. He's going to be revealed here in a second if he doesn't build a main somewhere. But it looks like a Gargoyle is gonna try to pick off that. There we go. Down goes another Chimera. And the Dreadlord is not going to cast anything anymore, I don't think. Demon Hunter is going to allow that to happen. And the Undead is going to try to buy time for his Lich. Is he even getting his Lich back? He has an Acolyte right here. I don't know what he's waiting for. He has enough money. That was a level 6 Lich? Yeah, level 6 Lich. He has enough money, but does not have enough he does not have enough food. So now I think Green's gonna fight this and GG out. No, he's gonna TP out. What? He had a. Oh, he didn't have no crop lift somewhere. I didn't know that. Looks like he's basically gonna be completely ravaged. He lost his tier 3 tech. Did he rebuild something? He rebuilt an altar. And he's gonna have to rebuild all the Ziggurats to supply that one hero. And these fairy fires are gonna reveal Doc Green as to where he is. Watch. This is Doc Green's vision. He's gonna see the humans pushing him, and he's gonna see these gargoyles with the fairy fire. So that's pretty good.
Our warriors have engaged the
free-for-all game. But anyway, Doc Green's gonna lose all the Moonwells. It looks like this one Demon Hunter's gonna be coming back, and three heroes are gonna be staffed back. I think he tried to defend it because the whole thing. Teal is gonna make the same mistake again. Try to focus down the Demon Hunter, but this time no more Moonwell Man. I try to save him. Now he's doing the right thing. Focus down the Chimeras, and towers are gonna be up. Chimeras are gonna have to back off. Chimeras are gonna go down pretty fast versus Griffin because of splash and magic damage are going to be pretty deadly versus Chimeras. That Archmage is gonna be fighting solo from here. I don't think Human wants to even bother to try to revive with these two heroes, which is a mistake because. What is that? Level 1? Oh, never mind. 1-1. Now I know why he's not reviving anybody. His tower push is completely failed, and at least he bought some time for Green's base just to save all the Ziggurats. Here comes the Lich. I think. Nope. Never mind. Level 9 Demon Hunter now. Green. Oh yeah, he's timing his Lich out, so. That's gonna be okay. But although the Fairy Fire is still on his Frostworm, has no destroyers to get that out of there because he lost his tier 3 tech, which means you cannot make any more statues. And what is he talking about? He's gonna reveal everything. No, Fairy Fire ran out, so finally. I think that's one of the reasons Blizzard nerfed the Fairy Fire because in free for all games, it's pretty imbalanced. You can reveal anything you want for like 20 minutes. what is Teal doing? Okay, Teal is going to try to hit Green, and Teal is going to back off. Although these Griffins are pretty tough to deal with, especially when the Archmage popped a potion of a score of protection on them. Pretty tough without a big gargoyle force. Green's going to run out of money here in a second. Yep, two gold mines are about to get like a green. So are these two going to gang up on Dr. Green? That's going to feed him experience. Although there could be a chance as long as they don't A move because they can attack each other in the next battle if they both decide to go in the same time. Is Doc Green going to hit Green again? Yep, he is. He is going to go straight to his base. Chimera is going to be brought over. Green is going to try to occupy this gold mine. I don't think that's going to be allowed. He's on that main. I'm dead. Go, hurry. Somebody. So Teal is going to follow the orders, and I don't know what Doc Green is going to do. Does he have a TP? He has got a TP somewhere here. On one of these heroes. No, he does not have a TP. You have troops, 48 food, he's got all alter heroes. Ultimate heroes. Oh god, Doc Green is going to buy some time for his Teal ally to hit Doc Green's base. Doc Green does not have a TP, remember that. But it has two mains for some reason, I don't know. Anyway, Teal is gonna show up here, and look, I think Doc Green's gonna try to kill off Green. Green's gonna try to buy as much time as he can, so the Teal can finish off Dr. Green. This becomes a really sophisticated strategy. What's that name of the game? Strategy, yeah. That's strategy, what the fuck? Anyway, Green's gonna try to buy more time. Green just keeps telling Teal to go. Dr. Green's gonna try to buy TP, wrong shop. The real shop is over here, buddy, at the 6 o'clock, and not over there, but he's going to try to kill Dreadlord. Is he going to be coiled? No, Dreadlord is going to be sacrificed. Level 9 Panda, about to be level 10 Demon Hunter. Oh, God. Demon Hunter is going to... Oh, see Demon Hunter? Green's like, what? That's Nova to kill another Druid of the Talon. That's a TP, and it looks like Demon Hunter... DK is going to try to... do another coil, I think, but he TP'd out, no problem. Fairy Fire is gonna reveal him though, so that's no good. Teal almost finished off Doc Green's base. Is Doc Green food block? He's not. Where are the hell are these Moonwells? Did he rebuild Moonwell somewhere? What the hell? Oh no, because he has too many mains. Two Moonwells, 1, 3, 4, I think somewhere here. Four freaking tree of lives. That's how he stayed above a food block. But he's gonna lose a lot of moonwells. He was forced to rebuild them all here. He doesn't have enough wisp to build moonwells. I think he's gonna go for all dots from now. Try to counter that big griffin army. One griffin is gonna be caught. And remember, green is not killed off yet. He only lost one hero in that exchange or distraction, whatever you call that, against Dr. Green. Dr. Green is gonna try to come back and defend his base. Teal is long gone. Where the hell is Teal, by the way? Level 6 AM, yeah, he can go anywhere he wants. Like, he can just have all these peasants build farm all around the map. He can just teleport, go, drives you insane. I've been in that position before. I just want to smash my keyboard to the monitor. Oh god, good thing I haven't, because my monitor costs $250 and my keyboard costs about $5. Unrelated topic, I'd really like those cheap keyboards to play video games. One reason, because you can smash the crap out of them. Second reason is because they're really squishy. Anyway, Doc Green is going to be catching the Lich! Mana burn, not enough! Escape with 30 HP! Holy god, and it's still going down! What? Oh, Orb of Venom, that's right. God. But still, Orb of Venom effect is not enough to kill anybody. It's going to reduce your HP to 1 and then wear off. And which means Lich is going to be happily living. Winning! Oh god, it's been almost an hour. My throats are dry as hell. And is Teal going to tower up here, or is he going to mass teleport to one of the peasants? I don't know. His alchemy is definitely trapped. There's mass teleport, and I don't know if Doc Green can keep up with that mass teleport BS. Here comes the TP, and alchemy needs to back off now. Dude, run! Before you get mana burned. Oh, Jesus Christ. There's a Breath of Fire, Drunken Haze. Alchemy needs to teleport, the mass teleport right now. Forget about rendezvous with the Griffins. Griffins are going to be fine rejoining you. Teal is going to back off. But still, I think what Dr. Green should have done is land all these dots and cyclone that Archmage, so he won't be able to run away like this. Forget about the dots, forget about the Griffins in the air. At least like land two or three dots, and one of them has got to have enough mana to do a cyclone. And Teal looks like he's going to go straight back to his base, back to his little cradle. Who the hell left? Oh, Observer left. Okay, never mind. I think Observer is sick and tired of this 1 hour free-for-all game. Every Griffin has a fairy fire on them. You just need one to do anything. Anyway, Green, I don't know what Green's doing. Is he creeping around the map trying to get some money? I don't know. Demon Hunter looks like he's sick and tired of this mass teleport BS. He's not going to charge into the human forest. I think he's waiting for the Priestess of the Moon Starfall so he can do some damage to these towers, although the splash damage might be enough. Is Green... I think Teal needs to send Green the signal to hit Doc Green, because Doc Green does not have a TP, I don't think. He has a TP, one TP on the Priestess of the Moon. That's Water Metal block right there to save the Archmage from a mana burn, although I don't know if that's intentional. How's Doc Green? Teal hitting me, so Green is going to get the Ghost Switch. He's going straight after. I think he's better off just hitting here instead of all the way here. There's nothing left except the Moonwell. He did deny base over here, but I don't know if that's enough. 8, 6, 7. So he can just nuke and run if he wants to. Nuke and TP with your Lich should be enough. And I think Doc Green is finally doing the right thing. Kill one at a time. Don't TP back. Like he did last time. Kill one at a time. He has more than enough money, I think. Yeah, more than enough money to rebuild. Has had four expansions at the same time. Demon Hunter went down! What? Holy god! Focus fired by the towers, and now Doc Green's pissed. He's pissed off. The Archmage might as well just mass teleport out of there, but the Panda's gonna be the next target. Panda better be careful. Power needs to focus fire this Panda. Panda is gonna be killed. Don't turn around. Oh my god, what is he doing, dumbass? And I don't think Doc Green, I don't think all these money is gonna support Doc Green here. Holy God, I don't see it. I don't know how the hell he lost two heroes in 30 seconds. Really, really not paying attention. Has nobody blamed but himself. He could have just TP'd with the Priestess of the Moon or passed the TP to the Demon Hunter. And I think Green is looking for... you may actually win this. Green may be looking for where Doc Green is. Doc Green's got, the only thing he can make is dust. He can make some fair dragons. Actually not, he cannot, because he does not have tier 2, is that right? Is being desecrated. I don't know, two altars are building simultaneously. There's a Dark Ritual, that leaves Dark Green no choice but to get the time of the heroes back. Try to defend against this whole thing. And here's a, I think the Dark Ritual is cast in the wrong place, I think. There's a Cyclone to stop the Dark Ritual. Demon Hunter is gonna soak up all the Moonwell juice. There's this. Here's a Inferno down. Oh god, Lich is gonna be coiled! And Lich is gonna be blocked inside by the Dreadlord. Dreadlord is gonna sleep the Demon Hunter, actually. There goes the staff to save the Panda. Where the hell the Panda go, I have no idea. But Lich is stick around for too long. Another coil saved the Lich. And where the hell is Shade? Where are his Shades? Another coil saved the Lich again. This is what you get for not having any mana on the Demon Hunter. And the Dreadlord is going to be tossed in the air for some reason. I think anybody who needs to toss is tosses Lich. Demon Hunter went down. Where the hell is that Panda? Panda's staffed over here. Oh, he's on the way back. I think that's going to be the end of Doc Green. He's going to run out of money here. Yep, that's it. Yep. Panda's going to surround. Is he going to split surround? That's going to be ghostly move if he does. But, I think, yeah, Green can just run around until Panda split rejoins again and nuke the crap out of him. Dreadlord, get coiled! DK is gonna be tossed in the air one more time, but the Lich is going to, what is Lich going to do for the Dreadlord? I have no idea. I have no effing idea what's going to run with the Dreadlord. Maybe he was, never mind. Earth needs to be careful. If Earth wanders too far, Panda rejoins and can join on Earth first, and he is going to be nuked here if he is not careful. There's another coil to save the Dreadlord, and now Panda's rejoined to Earth. This is what you get for not listening to me. You wander the Earth way too far. There's a block. Yeah, that's a surround. Yeah, that Panda's going to go down. Panda can TP out though. I don't know if he wants to. Game is over anyway. We got saviors. TP? No, he didn't TP, so he gave up. I think Dark Green gave up because he didn't TP out to save the Panda. He's rebuilding though. I don't know why he didn't re. Yeah, he's rebuilding. Why didn't he TP? What? What in the hell? People amazes me sometimes. Although this is more than an hour into a game. If you had, like, I don't know, 200 APM, your hands gotta be tired by now. I have six, what does that mean? Six peasants? Well, six what? What do you have six of? Six peasants, yeah, he meant that. From some towers, so Teal anywhere. He's completely out of money. I don't see how he's gonna get more money though. okay. I'm gonna speed up the replay because Green and Teal are gonna attack each other soon. And the Dark Green is way, way out of the game until his Panda gets revived. I think there. Panda's Panda's gonna be taverned out. Actually, he's gonna soak up some Moonwell juice. I think he better off getting a shop. Oh god, he's gonna. Oh god, the Drudel Town is gonna waste all the mana on these peons. He might as well kill them off to save some mana on your dots. There's a shop I was looking for. It's amazing how Doc Green made it so far without a staff. Without a freaking staff. Teal calls GG. Why? Oh, I think both of them think that Doc Green does not have any buildings left. Oh god, Doc Green's gonna come back. Is he gonna come back versus the teamers? I don't know. I really hope he does, because the teamers are one of the lamest thing you can do in free-for-all, because it's a breach of a contract, to be honest. A verbal contract between you and when you join the free-for-all. It is free-for-all, so you can do anything you want. Down goes the Wisp. Oh god, if Green and Teal don't find this freaking base soon, they're gonna be completely owned. Here we go! 999. All of them about to be level 10. And that is going to see it? No, I don't think so. And that is going to be pretty cocky, I know that. And ooh, don't get mana burned. There we go. Nice, nicely done. There's a coil on the dot. That dot is going to be taken down without any frost. What do you call that? Fairy fire. There's another inferno here. Pushing lesser invulnerability being used on the priest's moon right away. DK is going to be focus fired, and DK has a TP. No! Oh my god! Holy Jesus! That was close. Almost a Nova on the priest's moon. I don't think that was going to be relevant. Is Teal going to get some money or what? He can distance mine. Although the only gold mine left is over here and over here. Nope. So only gold mine left is right here. Actually, there's the gold mine here.
Our warrior gate.
That's it. I thought there's no more gold mine left. It's rare you see any Warcraft 3 map, any Warcraft 3 game where the players mine out the entire map. I think the only other game I can think of is the one on my account where a human and orc battled out for 2 hours and 10 minutes. The human throwed everything at the orc, like. I'm talking about tier 2 tower rush to casters and motor team push to mass air, and then later on to that's it. He threw everything at the orc defended every wave, and the two players mine out a secret valley. I think you gotta watch that replay if you haven't watched it, although I doubt anybody finished that replay. Because it's 2 hour long. If you think about it, you have to designate 2 hours of your time, most likely over 2 days, to watch the entire thing. And it's going to be pretty painful. Al is going to see this entire undead base, and he's not going to see any gold mines. The only gold mines is here left, it's here, and Dark Green is going to take it. And it looks like Akala is going to try to sell a lot of things, and let's see who's going to prevail here. Dark Green is going to try to finish off the buildings. What is Teal doing? Is Teal still here? Teal left. He GG'd out. How did I not catch that? So I really don't know, Jesus. Okay. Green's gonna try to play stay, keep away, but he cannot base trading against Nano. Although, he can land a pretty good Dark Ritual over here, a Death and Decay over here. Try to draw the Nano back to defend it. There's a Coil Nova on the Demon Hunter. Demon Hunter is gonna be Nova again. Demon Hunter is gonna be focused. Demon Hunter needs to be careful. Demon Hunter needs to be careful! What? No micro whatsoever from Dark Green. What? He could have used that Metamorphosis and gained some poop. What does that mean? Pop effing ultimate 2x? What does that mean? Anyway. He could have popped the Metamorphosis to gain some HP, but I don't know if he's Metamorphosis on cooldown, maybe. But still, he could have used the ultimate on the Panda to cyclone the Lich or something to slow down damage per second, and use the Taunt to even slow down the damage even more. Dark Rain's pissed. I really don't know who to call here, because... Dark Green's gonna try to sell some things, and probably gonna tavern the hero back, although you know he's gonna make the out of the altar. I think Green's first priority to hunt down that Demon Hunter if he's ever come out of the altar, or he's either come out of the altar or from tavern. He's gonna hop over the tavern first, didn't see anything. And the Panda's gonna be hunted down, looks like. There we go, yep. Panda's gonna split, actually. There's a cyclone. That's a lot of gargoyles! Holy god! And is Panda's gonna die? No, there's no way, right? That wind needs to be focused on first. Wind can be Nova if necessary, or Coil. No, down goes wind. Fire needs to, Earth needs to run. Earth does have heavy armor, so the gargoyles won't do additional damage. But looks like he's not gonna escape it. Nova Coil is gonna do it. Try to do a stone maze, which means stone form maze. Surround! Stoneform surround! Oh, I love to see that! Oh, I love to see a Stoneform surround! Earth is gonna... Stoneform now! Oh, god! Because I think it's too much pain on the free-for-all game. But the Green is gonna try to chase the Panda. Breath of Fire, Drunken Haze! That's gonna be a big mistake, because there's another sleep, I think. I didn't even need sleep. Down goes the Panda! It's gonna be staffed! Oh, God. Panhead's gonna be stopped. Where, though? I should have coiled. Yeah, you freaking cheap bastard. Where the hell is Panda? Here we go. And but the Priestess of Millions of Wine is going to be in trouble. She has a TP. I think she has to burn it. Where the hell is the Demon Hunter? Demon Hunter is going to be chilling over here just to let that bitch go, I think. If you land the Stormform correctly, you can just block the Priestess of the Moon. But looks like the Green is going to try to surround. There we go. Nice surround. Now he's going to have to TP out. So that's going to tip off Green where... there's a base somewhere for Doc Green, although he wasn't revealed for a while, so there's got to be a base somewhere. Anyway, holy god, level 10 DK? See, my hero can't do that. Just nuke the crap out of you. Yeah, my heroes can't do that. Your heroes can. I don't think this is where you want to go, dude. You might as well just leave these things alone. And nope, okay, he's going to try to kill this tower. And yeah, Panda's gonna come back, soak up some Momo juice, and we're gonna see three hero versus three hero finale for this epic free for all number two, right? Right? If Dr. Green decides to micro his Demon Hunter a little, maybe we're gonna see a better result. But I don't know what happened here. What is going on? Okay, that's interesting. Priest of the Moon is about to hit level 10 here in a second. Watch. His Green's gonna come back, try to come back and defend. Where is his. Okay, he's gonna have a bunch of buildings over here. Nothing over here left. Nothing over here. So he's gonna use Staff of Teleportation to get out. Meanwhile, yeah. This Inferno has gotta expire here in a second. Mind that whole time. I think. Let's put on the Green's vision. He knows there's a gold mine over here because he scouted every other place. Everywhere is mined out, so he knows there's a gold mine over here. Why did he send a shade or something over here? Or is he gonna go finally to the 12 o'clock or what? I think he is. He's gonna run into three heroes and we're gonna set up a big three hero finale, although these gargoyles can make a difference, a small difference, but difference nonetheless. Drunken Haze, the Breath of Fire, they're gonna catch a lot of gargoyles. Here's Drunken Haze. I think they're gonna have to go to Stormform now. Stormform, there we go. Get that Drunken Haze out of there. Nicely done. And Demon Hunter is slept, and I think, oh no, I have it on two, half the speed. Here we go. We're gonna see the Priest of the Moon is gonna get nuked right away. Inferno is gonna get summoned. Demon Hunter cannot do anything in the back. And Priest of the Moon was forced to pop the potion lesser invulnerability. And what's going on? Panda is going to be focused down first. A is going to be killed first. Priest of the Moon is going to be next. All three undead heroes are going to be focused down him. Down goes the Priest of the Moon. Demon Hunter is the only one left. And I don't know. Oh, crap. I don't know. I don't know if Demon Hunter can defend this by himself. I'm talking about 10-9-9 heroes. Oh, God. Yeah, this is not. I don't care what a Superman you are. This is your Rex Luthor. There's a Stormform made! Yes! Stormform block! Bitch! Get out of my game! Knock mofo. Oh god, is this the end? Is this the end of the game? If I were Dr. Green, I would quit because I got my two alters discovered. How much money did he have anyway? Yeah, sorry about that. My computer just crashed, and you guys didn't miss much. The green clear of this, the two altars and bunch of moonwells you saw in the last video, and I boot up the. My computer had a blue screen of death. Guess what? That battle was so epic. I'm gonna blue screen death you, motherfucker. And now, but yeah, I think these players are gonna chat. I don't know if we're going to see another epic battle, although there's about 20 minutes left in this replay, so I really don't know if Green can rebuild. If he can somehow sneak in an altar somewhere and mine out this entire gold mine, he can rebuild all three heroes. Let's see, where's he at? Hide two Moonwells here. They're all whisked around, and I really don't know where is he going to build the altar. Maybe he can build it, like, right here or something. Like, yeah, right there. Right there. Like using Bin Laden's tactic, live right next to a Pakistan military base and see if they find you. Yeah, of course. Yeah, there's no doubt in my mind. Yeah, Pakistani military is not hiding Bin Laden. Yeah. He lives in the freaking fortified building, no internet, no phone, garbage is burning inside, never taken out. about what, half a mile away from a military base. He, ooh, nice detonate. He wasn't getting support from Pakistan government. No, not at all. $1 million building? Nah, he built himself, brick by brick. He laid the bricks, he poured the concrete, he painted the whole wall, and he built a carried all the bricks from the construction yard to his house. He built everything himself, and he got all the furniture in himself. He set up all the TV and all the electricity stuff. Got all the meters and water running. Did it all by himself. Nobody helped him. Down goes Doc Green's last mining base, and Green's gonna be revealed here. Doc Green's gonna be revealed here. He hasn't built anything yet. Let's see if that's the case. His altar. Whoa, that's a hidden altar. I never find that. Here comes Panda though. Here comes the Demon Hunter. And Goggles are gonna try to hunt down the wisps, and Green's gonna be so nervous right now. Doc Green's gonna be so nervous. Please don't find any of my shit. Does he have a? He doesn't have a main though. Where are Green? Green's over here, fucking around the middle of the map. Looks like Doc Green is gonna be allowed to have all the heroes back, but he's gonna be revealed. He is definitely gonna be revealed, or unless I'm missing a Tree of Life somewhere. Is that it? Nope, that's a wisp. True love is so freaking hard to see, especially when they uprooted. It's a little dot on the minimap. You gotta watch for it. So the wisp is gonna build a tree of life. He has enough money, might as well build one, just not to get your building discovered. Well, he doesn't care anymore. Yeah, he is definitely revealed because his altar is gonna be discovered here, and the priest of the moon looks like he's gonna get denied. But he's gonna get her back from here though. Demon Hunter is gonna finish, and there's a breath of fire try to draw the Green out to attack him. But looks like Green. Oh yeah, the altar is not flashing anymore. Oh, the Panda's gonna be. Oh, there's a Stormform surround. Nice. Oh no, we missed a spot. Oh no, never mind. He got it. Panda does not have. I don't think Panda has anything. Nope. Panda's gonna split to get out. But the Earth is in the middle still. So as long as Green leave Earth alone, no, don't, no, what are you doing? As long as you leave Earth alone over there in the middle of the Stormform, he's gonna rejoin at Earth. Someone should have told him that. I think he's focused on wind and then fire and then finally Earth. That's the correct way if you wanna kill all three. You don't have to kill all three. You can leave in the middle of Stormform and he's gonna rejoin him. Tana's gonna go down. Okay, that works, but it's a harder way to do it. My way, you're gonna lose a few gargoyles, but you can coil them though, while they're in their storm form. Here comes Demon Hunter, pissed off mode. He's gonna kill all Green's buildings. Let's see Green lose all his shit before the game is over. Down goes the Acropolis. Looks like these three buildings are gonna be targeted one by one. Although Demon Hunter doesn't want to reveal where he is, because here comes Green. Green, let's see if he has any money left. He has, nope, absolutely nothing left. He can sell all the items and try to get a, nice tree of life is going to be discovered. Coil the Wisp. He can sell all his items, including the orb, that's the only thing, include the TP. He doesn't have a main, I don't think. He just got his last main killed. So he's not gonna have a main to TP to anyway. He might as well sell the TP. He just passed the shop. He can sell the TP, sell the orb, get a necropolis, like hidden necropolis somewhere. But the Demon Hunter's gonna be discovered. Coil Nova, swarm, and we're gonna see the Demon Hunter try to duke it out here. Stormform block. No, missed it. But block the decay inside. But sleep is gonna to. He's going to get the Demon Hunter there. But you got a Stormform blocking one more time. Nova coil on the another sleep, and I think that's gonna be it. You're gonna round around until you coil Nova. There we go. Level 10. 10, 10, 10. Oh, wait. 10, 9, 10. Oh, nice. Oh, God. Oh, man. This is gonna be a freaking orgasmic for undead player. But, there's still. You have two, three buildings left. One Starfall is gonna take all three down. So you gotta be careful with this thing here, especially when the Panda comes out, if the Panda ever comes out. Is the Panda coming out? I don't think he has enough. He doesn't have enough money to revive either of these heroes. He can only do with his Priestess of the Moon, although she can sell some stuff and revive another hero. I think that's what she's doing, but she doesn't know where Undead is. She's gonna have someone out, to spot Undead army for him. I think Undead just spotted this. because he's got to be revealed. I just no reason. He saw the altar. He's still queuing all the waypoints around the mini map. Oh, it makes me dizzy. But the priest of moon is gonna summon an owl. He's gonna try to. Oh God, there's another man here. Holy Jesus! Priest of moon is gonna reveal herself. She has a staff of teleportation, and she doesn't have enough mana to do a starfall. I think it's 250 mana to do a starfall. I think. But he's gonna pick off a ziggurat. That's gonna draw the entire undead army on your ass. It's not even funny. There we go. There's a staff of teleportation. I think the owl spotted these incoming undead heroes. Owl should be just tagged to the lich. If I were the owl, I would just follow the lich until I don't know when. But anyway, the undead knows there's moon out here. There's an altar here. What is he waiting for? What? I have no idea what the hell is going on. But apparently he's blind on his minimap. Dark Green was revealed. He's got to be revealed. There's no other way. He's still queuing up around. What are you doing? He can just click this button here to make your opponent be red on the minimap, and then he can spot it. And then, never mind, he's going to see it. He's going to see it with a gargoyle. So let's see if he goes over there. Is he paying attention? Nope, he's going straight over there. Seeing the altar is flashing, that's a big indication that you got to take the altar out. Here comes Green. Is Green going to win this game, or Dark Green is going to have a miraculous comeback? Let's see. The pandas, I don't think he's going to come out on time. Priest of the Moon is trying to draw undead back to his base. I don't know if the panda's going to come out on time. As long as there's an inferno here, it can do chaos damage. But looks like the Dreadlord is going to be the one coming back to try to do some sleeping. Oops, what the hell? And to try to do some sleeping against this Priest of the Moon. Almost level 10, I don't think. Level 2 Isle Scout is going to help him a lot. And is there a second altar somewhere I'm not seeing? There's a tree. Oh, there's a tree. He's not revealed then. But he does not have an altar anymore. There's a wisp here. He can build one if he wants to. But the gargoyle is going to discover the tree and the priestess of the moon. And that's going to be game, I think. I think Green is going to converge over here. Second gargoyle is drawing the battle. First gargoyle is going to go stone form. Second one is going to come in. And I don't see an altar anywhere unless he's going to try to tavern one of the hero back. He has not enough money to do it. He just used something. He just spent it on something. I don't see where. But the Priest of the Moon is going to be completely... Let's see here. Is there an altar? He's used a wood to try to build an altar, I think. But here comes Undead. Here's the DK. He's going to coil the stone gargoyle. He's going to hide, which means that's bias Undead time. There is leave the game. Are you entertained?